Guys, thank you for clicking on this video. Welcome to the channel. If it's your first time here, my name is Kostas Lozanis. In today's video, I am gonna give you guys a complete masterclass from start to finish on how I cater special events. Today, we're actually gonna be catering a wedding. Hope you guys learned some stuff from this. If you're not into catering, I'm still gonna make it as fun as possible. Stick around.
All right, so I am here with Savannah. You are the event coordinator, yes. The venue planner, all the things.
All the above.
What do you look for in a caterer?
So we really look for someone who's easy to work with, reliable, on time, comes prepared, so has all the equipment needed, knows the party count, and like is prepared for, you know, a good event and just has an optimistic attitude. You know, I think the worst thing was they got the time wrong. So they weren't ready to serve dinner till 2 hours after it was expected to be ready. So that was a little bit of a disappointment. And as a wedding planner and like a wedding coordinator, being the one in charge and saying, sorry, there's nothing I can do, that really sucks.
And there's nothing you can do. I mean, there's no food.
You can't whip up 60 plates in, you know, 10 minutes.
So. Yeah, I've heard so many horror stories with like cold food, mm-hmm. food falling apart, food not even arriving.
Yeah, food is not arriving.
All the things. Okay, cool. Well, there is some advice from an actual wedding venue. Now, if you want to start a catering company or if you want to get into catering, do you recommend just like calling venues up, or like how do you like get venues to know that you cater?
So definitely always having cards on you. I always ask for all my vendors' cards, and then just saying, yeah, I love to do a variety of things. The bigger your repertoire, the larger your group you cater to. So okay. Being that Opus is such a great at just diversifying their menus for guests, if you just do barbecue or you just do Mexican food, that's great. But the more you do, the more guests you're gonna reach.
Awesome, okay. Well, I'm gonna leave a link to the Little Wren wedding venue below this video. Make sure you check them out. Give them a look if you guys are looking for a place to host a wedding or a venue of any sort, right?
First thing first, before you even get started catering, before you start doing anything else, get your timeline in check. I am a big believer in hurry up and wait. You may have heard it in vlogs past, but there's so many unforeseen circumstances that occur whenever you're doing these things. You don't want to find yourself in a rough spot where you run out of time. Hurry up and wait, put that down on your checklist, and that can apply to other things besides catering. It's just a great rule to live by. Okay. I never thought I would be doing a lot of dope shots of my tote box, but literally I think I operated the first 3 years without this thing, just carrying stuff by hand. It had the nice pull out handle, the wheels, the side grips, they're stackable, so I got two of them. And in these boxes, I will put my plates, I'll put my coffee maker, I'll put my lighters, just anything that I need that's a dry storage. These are a lifesaver and they are indispensable when it comes to doing caterings.
When it comes to drink dispensers, make sure you never transport your beverage in the drink dispenser, because these, as beautiful as they are relatively fragile, and the last thing you want to do is have your liquid being crushed whenever you hit a stoplight on the way to the event. The only takeaway on these guys is make sure you have them, make sure you have all the parts, and I would give the spigot a little test, make sure they're not leaking. The last thing you want to do is get to an event and have a leaky drink dispenser. And if you guys remember my last vlog, when it comes to the actual transporting of the teas, we use these buckets here. I will put a lid on them like I did on this one. That way they transport without any possibilities of spillage.
My man Roger, he is actually getting a bunch of ice in his ice chest for us. He carries big 60-inch ice chests. We'll carry two or three of those if we need to, if there's like 100, 150 people. Today, we're just doing it for 50. Check with the wedding venue. A lot of these places are not gonna have any ice for you. Put it on the car so that way after he fills it up, it's not so heavy. You can just wheel it straight out to the catering van. Ice, if you don't have ice, like you're gonna be running to get ice. They have to figure out like a way to hold the ice. So ice is important.
Comes to cups, plates, forks, knives, all those things. If you go to some online websites, they say bring 5 cups per person. That's bogus. I've never used that many cups in my entire life of all the catering that I've done. 1.5 cups per person is usually more than enough. You can bring 2 per person if you like.
for non-alcoholic drinks. Obviously, when you start getting into like pouring mixed drinks and things like that, it's whenever, you know, you need 5 cups per person. I personally like to bring the plasticware, even if the guests say they can buy it. I just don't want to trust anyone else, because if they forget it, like, guess who looks bad? Like, I look bad. I don't want Uncle Bob that was in charge of the plates to not bring the plates, and guess what? Old Bugri Taverna ruined the catering event, you know? Or I have to like scramble and like run, and if it's like a wedding out in the middle of nowhere, I gotta drive an hour to like, I don't know, a gas station and buy paper plates. It's horrible. And this is my world.